interactive behavior. There's no engineer to supervise. There's no pre-programmed behavior.
Blue count.
Any program is generated online on the robot.
Blue count.
The only thing we give is a command at a high level, task level. Now you should recognize. Now you should learn. And you see attention system for both auditory and visual input.
Unknown object.
Cell phone.
Did you say cell phone?
Yes, this is correct.
Here, Asimo is shown an unknown object, and within this short time, he learns
cell
to
phone.
Recognize this object. At the upper left side, you see the image of the cameras of the Asimo. That means there's no easy way to segment the object. It's a very hard job to understand what is really an unknown object.
Cell phone.
And you see, immediately, within a short time, so practically on the fly, robot is able to learn. Now, we told him
what are these objects?
That in case of a toy, robot should point with two hands and other objects with one hand.
Toy tiger. Blue cap.
So again, all movements, all actions are
blue cap.
Online, developed and programmed and optimized on the robot. So the behavior is triggered by the interaction with the human partner. The person behind is only for being safe that in case the robot is failing, we don't
Toy
get the damage.
Toy duck.
So this free recognition and online learning of 3D objects in that way, with the incremental capability of learning new things, you will not see at any other system currently on the world. Now we show a first step to a scene representation. The robot is shown three objects at the same time, and the robot
SD can.
Is now selecting what are the possible objects and is fixating
SD can.
One object after the other, recognizing it and putting it in a kind of memory to keep
vegetable.
The object and the location of the object in his mind. So for next maybe
use, vegetable.
Where he has to grasp the object.
Toy tiger. Toy tiger.
So especially.